Hello. Today I'm working on more cutscenes. What I want to do is adjust or add an animation to the secondary dialogue bubbles. First of all, right now, let me get a spawn point so I can show you. I wasn't quite prepared. But right now, the speech bubbles just instantly appear, but I want them to kind of pop in to like scale in, I guess. I don't know. Some kind of simple animation to make it look nicer. We're just gonna add another spawn point. So that we can skip the first cutscene and these. I think I need to add more characters too. This is gonna crash. Well, Well, this makes absolutely no sense. Barry's in the party, but I don't know what changed that. He's not detected there. I think I might know what's happening. I don't know how I just now encountered this, but I think it's just the order the objects are being initialized and need the spawn to go first. Because it relies on the references of the characters. Okay, back to what I was doing. Currently, the secondary dialogue bubbles just instantly appear, but I'm gonna have them kinda, I don't know if I'll add a fade, some kind of like growing animation. Probably won't keep it, I'll probably keep it pretty simple. It'll be real fast anyway. I want to see where the, how the positioning is currently. I'll have it like grow from the person speaking. Dialogue window is positioned like this. I think I'll just have them scale up like that quickly. I have to figure out the positioning, which is going to be different for each bubble position type. Constant here. Action RPGs, is closer to CrossCode or Diablo or Secret of Mana? Secret of Mana, probably the closest thing. Secret of Evermore, especially if you played that, so I'm adding a similar alchemy system. But yeah, I'll have multiple characters in your party. Possibly local co-op would be really cool. Maybe online co-op too. Depending on how doable that is, but the focus will be single player. Let's add an animation time. Probably shorten it. To make it obvious while I'm working on it. Played Secret of Evermore, love the dog transformations and market section. Yeah, it's Evermore has a ton of charm. It's one of my favorite games. So there's definitely gonna be inspiration drawn from that this game. Very simple setup. We can do just the scale first, and then the position's gonna be a little harder. Followed the channel in 2014. Oh, okay. Yeah, I took a very long break. I started streamed a little bit development. And then didn't stream at all for probably like 4 years. 4 or 5 years. But picked it back up again this year for this game. Streaming more often than I ever have, so I got a pretty normal stream schedule nowadays with at least once a week. Now I'm moving to twice a week as well. I hope to have Twitch streaming be a big part of this game's development and release at some point as well. I like to have that community interaction. See what this does. I did Enchanted Cave. Enchanted Cave 1 and Enchanted Cave 2. They are my legacy. Congregate and a couple of other flash sites. There we go, we got a little thing there. Very ugly currently, but functional. We just have to adjust the location now. Get some movement along with it, and then speed it up at the end. Sank so many hours into that back in the day. Hoping to see it springboard over. It is on Steam now. That was a while back. Yeah, there's a lot more features in the premium version, and then I put out a big update that added some like challenge modes like a year later. Maybe 2 or 3 years later. That was more recent. But RPGs are definitely my go-to, so I'm leaning more towards the action RPG side of things nowadays. This project. I feel like roguelikes are still really popular, but they might, I don't know, might at some point be there on their way out. Checking it out, awesome. I hope you enjoy it. If you enjoyed the Flash game, I'm sure you will. Yeah, it's on Steam and mobile. We got basic percent. Now I need to adjust the position. add some extra variables when these positions get initialized. And then I'll use the difference at the end. All of this, I don't want to have to do it individually for every bubble location. I can do some math here. The end. Calculated, I think. Shame that roguelike's fallen out of favor. I've never played Secrets of Grandia. I did cater to them and make an alternate roguelike play mode. Ate up so much dev time. I haven't looked into that one. But yeah, they definitely boomed big. I think elements of them will continue to be popular. So at this point, this is zero. Okay, that's when it first spawned. That doesn't change. Let me just make sure that doesn't break anything. That shouldn't change it. Yeah, we're still good. Then also has some like slight movement dampening going on. I don't think I want to touch that. I probably want to change target position. Target to, instead of directly target, we want her. Plus, maybe? Okay. Not quite correct. Oh, it spawns like at their feet. This. Or this. Oh, I don't know. Might need to be minus. Kind of like half did something. Yeah, this isn't quite right. Let's see, I might be able. I always do that anyway. Very beginning of every case. Oh, it's also about UI scale. I also need to go through and fix all this for different resolutions at some point. But that's boring, so I'll do that off stream. Particularly boring. Just update target Y there. Don't do it here. That should work. Why is it starting so low still? So it does a weird little position change at the end. I think I want it just to be direct until the animation's done. Then we do the wiggle adjustments. That might be what's going on. Might have helped. Another thing I can do. You don't need it to start all the way at zero, percentage-wise. The animation. Start at halfway finished. Is it doing that? Oh, I do know why. I know why. Starting at half. Here we want. This looks better. I fixed it. That line is too quick. Change that. And get rid of these. And total animation. I'll make it quicker in a second. First, let's adjust this to like a fancier tween. Right now, it's just linear. Plastic, is that what I want? I want it to go like past and back. Bounce is not what I want. I wonder if this is the right thing. We'll just do quadratic. Looks pretty good. Final touch should be speeding up this. Make it twice as fast. So it's a little pop. And I'll probably fade it out. It's gotta stop doing that though. Some of it's gonna happen because the edge of the screen, it gets pushed around, but... I like it so far. Add a simple fade out. It's slow to start out with to test. We can reuse that variable. we'll just fade out the bubble for now, and then I'll have to do the text separately. Not right. No renderer. It's another. Let's do, instead of this, I'll just keep a reference to the bubble material. Bubble gets initialized and then material. Children. There we go. Need to add the text fading now. Of course, make it quicker. Functionality seems to be there. It's the text. Two different things. We got the text and the speaker name. Should be simple enough. Takes care of everything I need. Let's upload here. Nice. It's good, just need to make it fast now. See if 0.2 is too long. Kind of hard to see with the box showing. Yeah, that's too long. 2.1. Not funny doing so much work for something that just happens in a tenth of a second. But it makes a big difference. Even be faster. Does look a lot better though than before stream. Probably even faster. Fest. I mean, oh, wait, let's check that. Alright, let's see what we got here. Can I move my spot? Let's check back to where we left off, right here. Should I check that? I think I have a different scene on it. To my sample yelling scene. Started working on that a little bit. Continue that. What's up, Ethan? How's it going? I think I got a yelling scene. Yelling scene. Brand new scene to showcase the yelling part of the dialogue. I'm doing pretty well. Continuing on with some cutscene work. Game's coming along. As always. Alright, I haven't even tested this map out, so we'll see what happens. It's broken. That's what happens. Partially expected. event is yelling sample. Named it sample yell. You can't be doing that. Alright, that should fix that. First time testing this, it's very broken. I'll fix that though. First of all, in this scene, I only want Layla and Olivia. It's definitely looking better every week. So I must have it like default down or something. Okay, I don't even want to do that. It's just an incomplete addition there. Not moving at all. Off. Yeah, I want them to be walking as the dialogue showing. Olivia. playlist stays the same speed. We'll have to play around with all the speeds. Sir, really annoys me that the bubbles up. What's going on there? Bobble, then I'll adjust movements more. Try to figure out what's going on there. It's only happening once. Wrong. It's happening on a bunch. Maybe I didn't set it. That could be. Brand new dialogue, I might have just... I hope that's it. Yeah, here we go. Okay. Easy fix. What's up, Hughes Audio? Welcome in. Okay, the bubble's in the right spot now. Awesome. Get rid of that. Alright, I don't want her to fall back that far. Move her up a little bit. Figure out the issue with the mysterious rocks from last week. In the cutscene? I think that's probably what you're talking about. Yes, whatever it was, that cutscene is fixed. Here, I'll show it to you. But it's ready to go. Yeah, there were a number of small issues in that one. Oh. Gotta add all the people back. Yeah, so we got another cutscene in the books. Everybody regroups correctly. There's still like tiny little tweaks, like his elbow covering up the letters. But that's unrelated to this cutscene specifically. All good. Everybody's ready to go again. So now we're working on a little sample to showcase the yelling dialogue effect that shakes the screen. Great, thank you. So this will just be Olivia playing a joke. I need to adjust the movement a little bit more. It's actually not bad. Just continue on. It looks silly because it's only half a minute there. We wait. So Olivia yells boop. Wait a tenth of a second, and then Layla will scream. That is yelling sample 3. And also need. I will at some point. I don't currently have a surprised animation frame for her, but I will. But right now, we'll just do set player facing. Character, Layla, direction. Right? And then move player, no animation. She's just like jumping back. And later on, I'll add an actual surprised frame. Move left. 30 pixels. 100 speed. And then we'll play this dialogue. Why did Olivia turn around? It's close. They're a little too close. Let's have... And then Olivia's movement when she scares her is off. We'll have Layla jump back a little further. A little quicker. Then... step forward, not as far. I kind of want to, before I set Olivia's facing, I'd like to figure out why it's turning right. So I can understand that. She's facing the right way there. Then I have one small adjustment. So this is, I believe this is, Olivia's falling back. I don't want her to fall back that far. That, or maybe that's fine. It depends on her speed. I want to adjust her speed. Olivia fall back a little quicker. And then I want another object. Right now the camera's centered on Layla. I want it to center between them. It'll be right here. Move the camera during the scare scene, I think. Time 1 second, we'll see how that looks and adjust accordingly. And I think I want Olivia to do a short little step forward here. She says is not. See how this looks. Camera's still off. Why did she go for that? Weird. You move correctly. Alright, so we need to adjust some movements in the beginning. Close. Maybe if we adjust the camera tween. So, a few different ways to do this. And a lot of the timing. Got to her position first. I'm trying to time them to be the same. Probably rewrite some stuff to ensure they're the same. She gets to her spot. A little too fast. Let's slow this down. Adjust this. single number. Until it's timed right. There we go. Better. When I have it, I'll give Layla her surprised animation. Got another small cutscene we'll do, and we'll see. Back with the whole gang. Placeholder statue. Actually, this will be a trigger. One move, right three, yeah, that's fine. This event trigger. I'll trigger. Prologues. Let me see. Statue. I'm gonna take out statue. Statue. That's opposite. Rename. Is that how I do it? Oh no, do it in name. Okay. So, let's set the camera position, focus on the statue, object, position. So, we actually don't need this takes any objects, so we'll just do the statue itself. Like a slow tween. And let's see here. To create the dialogue. Statue 1. Some subtle here. Play the step up. Dr. Graves move around a little bit studying the statue, as he says these lines. Did that to finish this section. Thank you. believe that's what I got. That's pretty much our dialogue set up. That's you 1 to 6. Alright, so wait for followers to regroup. And then Olivia's gonna run ahead. Here, and then Seth up. A lot of like little character movements on this one. The forward. Layla, position. Here, we'll have Dr. Graves go over here. Let me see what this thing says. We'll have Graves move here. Olivia, as usual. Barry, run forward. And then Theo just hangs out somewhere. Olivia and Barry run forward at the beginning. Olivia, and Barry will run forward, say, wow, look at this. At the same time, the others can get in their initial positions. Olivia, Barry, Graves can go on up there. He doesn't care about cutting off Olivia. What is this, 1.2? I don't think I really need to wait for stuff. Wait for moves to complete, we'll see. Yeah, Barry. Theo just goes to his spot. I'll face up after they move. Well, all right, we'll see what that does. Something broken. Olivia, run forward. Let's forget to save the map. Oops. And that's not it, there's something else. Oh, I have Barry run for a price. Let's go. That. So at some point, I'm gonna fix the little pause there. I kind of need the followers, everybody, to like regroup in order to get the movements in the cutscene correct. But it is kind of weird how like pauses there. I can figure out a smoother transition. I think I made a note already of that. Let's check. Otherwise, it looks pretty good. I just want to, adjust the statue itself. The position's a little off. Like, centered based on the sprite and not its ground. Centered, that's good. Wow, look at this, and then nothing happened. Okay, so let's start. To move up. We got Olivia move forward. Barry or Olivia, you need to name these the same. Olivia, move up. Barry, move up. We'll have Theo step. Forward a little bit. And if everybody else is moving, it'll look weird to play the. Move in line with Olivia. Wait, I guess I do want to wait on everybody there. Here we'll wait for everybody's moves to complete. At some point, I want to make this a little easier to write, a little faster. Like it's a common tool I'm gonna need. To do it right now. We'll wait for everybody to get in position, then we'll move everybody up. Graves goes there. He's gonna move right up next to the statue. As they move, play this dialogue. Kayla asks, "You know who this guy is?" Let's see how I put this. Actually, I think I skipped one. Just have that so far. We have some movement on Layla. I have to adjust. Why don't I have that? Don't save correctly. Let's see where Graves ends up so far. Can move a little closer. That looks okay. Need to remove Olivia's dialogue. Wow, what happened there? So positioning of them is Oh, it's because being said as Olivia. It's why. Back and forth a little bit. I don't need objects for that. Let's just do the simple. Rest of the dialogue added. We'll see what happens here. Really like that reading pose. It's really good. Really like how that turned out. It'll look better once I get the actual art. Right now it's just Magus placeholder statue. So that the dialogue will make more sense. Love it. Alright, that's gonna be it for me today. A few more cutscenes finished. They're going a lot quicker now that I got most of the basic tools made. That's awesome, as usual. Thanks everybody for watching. Thanks for hanging out. I'll be back Monday, probably with some more art on the temple tile set. Let's see what we got going on here. I'll be back Monday. We're gonna raid Strawberry. She's playing some Cozy Breath of the Wild today. Stream's really great. Her community's really cool as well. Let's see. But thanks for watching. I will see you on Monday.